You know, Steph, as meteorologists in Central Alabama, we often hear people say they believe we're seeing more tornadoes than ever before, and the tornadoes are getting stronger, too.
That's right, and we wanted to investigate that claim. We wanted to see if there's actually some truth to it or if it's accurate, and so we started looking at some of the data. And so have tornadoes been getting stronger? Well, you're taking a look at the average number of tornadoes here in the state of Alabama when it comes to strong tornadoes, so EF3 or greater. And so this shows the average number over 50 years, the last 50 years, the last 30, the last 20, and the last 10. And what you'll notice is that the numbers remain relatively consistent until we get to the last 10 years. And the reason for that is because of that generational event, April 27th, 2011. If you take out that day from the data, you can actually see the number drops. And so the data suggests that in recent years, we have not been seeing as many strong tornadoes here in the state of Alabama. And as a matter of fact, we haven't had an EF5 tornado anywhere in the United States in the last 8 years or more, which is actually a record in and of itself. What about the sheer number of tornadoes, though, in the state of Alabama? Are those increasing? And so we have the average number of tornadoes here in the state of Alabama over the last 50 years, the last 30, the last 20, and the last 10. And this clearly does show that there is an increase in the number of tornadoes in Alabama in recent years. But that's not quite the full story. Technology is the main reason that we are seeing these higher numbers, with the advances in not only Doppler radar, but especially dual pole radar. Jerry?
And Steph, I think the numbers clearly show that. Now we're going to look at the number of weak tornadoes, mostly EF0s, maybe a few EF1s. And what you see in this graph is, look at the explosion in the number of those storms over the last 15, 18 years or so. Why is that? We think a huge reason is the fact that dual pole Doppler radar has now come into existence. And because of that, we're able to see things falling from the sky other than just raindrops. And that tells us maybe shingles are falling or other parts of buildings, anything like that. And that's caused the huge increase in the number of these weak tornadoes. Before this time, we just didn't see them. We didn't know they happened. Maybe they happened out over the countryside and we wouldn't even know about it. But the number's now coming up because of dual pole Doppler radar, and that's why we're seeing this big increase in the number of weak tornadoes, which of course leads to an increase in the total number of tornadoes too. Truly remarkable stuff. We're thankful for the technology. It's helped us so much, and the National Weather Service uses it all the time as well, and it's really a big help in forecasting these weak storms.
And I think the biggest thing, Jerry, is that we just always have to be prepared.